Hi and welcome back. You're gonna need something like this if you want to better understand what your chargers, cables, or USB power devices are doing. I really like this packaging because it came in a plastic envelope and afterwards we have this entire foam case. So let's open it together. Cut it around. All right. Some other protection. And this is the device itself. I don't actually know how to pronounce this. I think it's FNIRSI USB tester. Model is FNB58. And inside we have the device. And I think that's it. There are no instruction manuals, no warranty card. This is just a quality tester. That's it. So if we need more information about this unit, we'll probably need to go online. Let me clear the desk. Let's take the foil out. Really nice. Here we have a connection for the PC. It's a micro USB. The menu, which goes left, right, and push, a back button. We have here multiple connection types, USB type C, micro USB. These are both in connection and type C output. PD communication to be on or off using this switch. On the side here, we have an output and this is an input. All these connections, either you're using type C or micro USB, are all in parallel. What I found out is that the input is actually from this side. It's pretty strange for me since I'm not doing usually electronic repairs, but having the input on the male adapter seems a bit strange, but all of them are like this. Let's power it up and see how it works. For testing, I'm gonna take this power delivery cable from my monitor and I should connect it to type C input. If we look on the screen itself, I hope you don't have too much glare, we can see the provided voltage for the unit, consumed amps and total power. Nothing is consumed right now since I don't have anything on the output. You have here a stoplight which is now set to green. If I press the button, I can do a freeze frame and save that value for future reference. We have multiple menus that we can toggle by going left to right. A lot more information is available depending on the menu that you are in. We even have an oscilloscope available. And here we can access different applications, including fast charge. Now, I'm gonna go back to, let's say, this menu. Or, you know what, let's go to the standard menu. I want to test it out, see how this handles, for example, a Raspberry Pi unit. The power supply is not capable of supplying 5 volts at 5 amps. It seems that 1 amp only. Let me try and disconnect the unit and put an official Raspberry Pi power supply. Now, this is a very interesting message. It tells me that the power supply is not capable of providing 5 amps, even if this is indeed the official power supply. I wonder if this is because of the screen. We're still holding at 1 amp. Let's make another test. I'm gonna simply remove the USB that powers the screen. HDMI output is still connected, but I don't think that's gonna be an issue. And now we're gonna need to power it again. Starting up. Right now, I don't know if I have the message anymore since the screen is blank. We can see it pulls around 200 milliamps, 300 milliamps lower than with the screen. Or even lower, 0.5 amps, 0.6. with the unit started. So, well, see, in this case, I already can theoretically know how much the screen is consuming. But overall, this is a very nice tool. I think it will be very useful for my next videos, where I actually want to see what's the power consumption for certain devices that I'm testing. This way, I can also test the quality of my power supplies or even test out the cables when testing different electronics. That's it for this small video. I hope that you enjoyed it. And if so, please don't forget to like and subscribe.